Well, here we are at Saqqara, on the edge of the great desert west of the Nile. Saqqara is the oldest pyramid in Egypt, and it is quite a unique site. There's nothing like it in the whole country. As a matter of fact, the administrative complex that we've come to see here today includes great holes in the ground which we believe to be storage bins from a biblical event, the time of Joseph, when there was a 7-year famine preceded by 7 years of plenty. And today we're here to show you some of the remains, which are quite astonishing in relation to an event which we believe is very highly biblical.
We trudged over the scorched sand of the desert amid Egypt's oldest ruins. Through the friendly influence of Dr. Ali Hassan, Egyptian Director of Antiquities, my wife Josephine and I were now to descend into tunnels far beneath the earth. We had first to break wax seals on two doors. Soon we were in ancient chambers 110 feet under the desert. The walls were lined with shimmering blue tiles. Sadly, salt crystals have begun to invade the ancient walls. Salt was attacking many of the old stone monuments of Egypt, and this tunnel system was not escaping that destruction. We wondered, who used these tunnels 4,000 years ago? Why were they constructed? Egypt boasts a glorious past. Some 900 miles upstream from the mouth of the Nile sits Abu Simbel. Perhaps nowhere else in Egypt, perhaps nowhere else in the world, is there anything like Abu Simbel. In the 13th century BC, on the banks of the Nile, Rameses II commanded his architects to build two magnificent temples from adjacent pinkish sandstone cliffs. The work is said to have taken up to 15 years. An artist of the National Geographic Society tries to capture the event. In one cliff, Rameses carved out a jewel-like temple dedicated to his beautiful wife, Nefertari. In another cliff, just 100 steps distant, workmen smoothed away the surface to a height of 110 feet and there carved four colossal 67-foot figures, all seated, all alike, of Rameses himself. Each would weigh 1,200 tons. Tunneling 200 feet inside the cliff, the builders then hollowed out great halls. Chamber after chamber they adorned with carvings of great beauty. Here the ideals of Egyptian sculpture, grandeur and solemnity are carried to perfection. One may imagine the pomp that attended the dedication of this temple. The beat of drums, the blast of trumpets, and the clanging of other musical instruments as the monarch and his queen led the procession, followed by the priest.
Right.
For a while after Rameses' death, the priests continued to maintain the temples. But by 1000 BC, Lower Nubia had begun to fade from the pages of history, and the sands of the western desert started to invade the great temple. Abu Simbel had obviously been forgotten by classical times, else it would surely have been listed as one of the seven wonders of the world. In 668 BC, two Greek mercenaries climbed the sand hills to carve their names on the statues. In 1813, 2,500 years later, Swiss traveller John Burkett travelled far up the Nile and stumbled upon this remote spot. He gasped as he saw the tops of four immense statues poking out of the sand. In 1817, Gianavi Balzani, an Italian who disguised himself as an Arab, penetrated the sand barrier. He went in with torches. Eventually, much of the sand was cleared away from the front outside. In the 1870s, Amelia Edwards visited and wrote about her visit. Inside is a dim chamber where two lines of towering figures of the Pharaoh as Osiris confront one another across a central aisle. Still deeper and much darker is the inner shrine where the king sits side by side with the supreme gods, Amon, Horus and Ptah. At any time, Abu Simbel is an awesome sight, but at the moment of dawn, it is incredible. When the rising sun tops the mountains across the river and flashes full on the facade, the figure of the sun god seems animated by the sudden light, as though to step forward to greet the morning. First rays briefly shine through the entry, penetrating the darkness to strike the four gloomy deities 180 feet within the bowels of the mountain. Ramesses is one famous name from ancient Egypt. Another is Tutankhamun, who was buried in a $6 million coffin. However, Tutankhamun is famous for the reason that his was the only unspoiled grave found in our time. While other tombs had been robbed long ago, Tutankhamun's tomb was hidden by rubble. It was discovered in 1922. Despite the unbelievable wealth found stored in his tomb, Tutankhamun was really a comparatively minor personage in ancient Egyptian history. However, in the Third Dynasty, there does appear a most incredible individual in the ancient records, a man called Im-hotep. Our archaeological team in Egypt has come face to face with many surprises. Among the most amazing of them all is this man, Im-hotep. The story of Im-hotep uncannily parallels the story of the biblical Joseph. Of course, scholars have claimed that there is no evidence that the biblical stories actually occurred, that there is no evidence that the ancestors of the Jews ever lived in Egypt, or that Joseph ever lived.
However, I shall share with you an astonishing story.
I have called it In a Coffin in Egypt. For many years, Egyptologists had even doubted that Im-hotep had been a real person. They found it difficult to believe the various accomplishments credited to him. Im-hotep has been termed the Leonardo da Vinci of ancient Egypt, but he was more than that. Da Vinci gained the reputation of a genius. Im-hotep was eventually elevated to the status of a god. The historian Manetho wrote that during his reign, that is, the reign of Zoser of the Third Dynasty, lived Imhotes, that is, Im-hotep, who, because of his medical skill, has the reputation of Asclepius, the Greek god of medicine among the Egyptians, and who was also the inventor of the art of building with hewn stone. Now, it is this statement that caused specialists to doubt the existence of a real man named Im-hotep. But in 1926, the question was settled once and for all. Im-hotep was a real man. When excavations were carried out at the Step Pyramid of Saqqara, south of Cairo, fragments of a statue of Pharaoh Zoser were found.